The Premier has unveiled the planned high-tech features of the new sports stadium. Super screens, Wi-Fi access and even radio commentary in the toilet. But the opposition has accused Mr Barnett of using the stadium fanfare as a diversion from his cost-cutting. Esse Deves reports.
Inspecting the Burswood Stadium site this morning, the Premier and his Sports Minister, Terry Waldron, appeared pretty happy with the progress.
Not exactly the middle, but you're not far off.
Announcing further details about the high-tech stadium, fans will be able to keep track of the action, even when they leave their seats.
There will be two giant screens installed in part of the stadium. There'll be over 1,000 television monitors.
We'll actually have audio in the toilet, so you can listen to the footy or the rugby or the soccer while you're actually going to the toilet.
The specifications submitted to the vying building companies.
The three bidders have until December to submit a fully costed response to the government, with the selected company chosen in June next year.
With construction scheduled to start 6 months after that, the Premier says so far the project's on budget and on time. And while he was today peddling positive news, he couldn't escape the backlash from massive education job losses and funding cuts announced earlier this week.
In my opinion, the education of our children is more important than radios in toilets. It's a pity, I think, that Mr Barnett doesn't think the same.
In the latest blow for education, it's been revealed a program which helps students improve their literacy and numeracy as well as behaviour will also have its funding slashed by 30%, meaning less support in the classroom.
Inevitable. When they're taking out, you know, $50,000, $100,000 out of a school and some FTE, some staff, there will have to be adjustments and some cuts.
Esse Deves, 10 News.